Son's name, Jesus. That's Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
John Yearby.
Microphone.
Hey. Check, one, two, check.
Well, y'all got this.
Amazon.com.
I can fill out the speaker and walk around with it.
There you go.
Street preacher. It's all good. Can y'all hear me?
Yeah.
Can y'all hear me, right? All right, praise the Lord. Like always, it's an honor to be here for you, for my community.
How long y'all had this?
A couple weeks.
Is it a couple weeks?
Yeah.
I got plenty of room. I ain't going nowhere. But it's an honor to be here with you guys. It's always a blessing to come out here and be able to share the word. I thank God for this ministry. The biggest thing is like we family. You know what I'm saying? Like we family. And I love it. You know what I'm saying? I love it. It's like we family. We have family in heaven, right? We connected. We connected to the body. We connected to him. And it's just a blessing to be a believer on the day. Like for real. Like to really abide in him and really like know that we have salvation. Like we have eternal life. Like that's the main thing. We can't never forget that. Guess what? He died for us and like literally paid everything for us. You know what I'm saying? Like he literally paid everything for us. And I think sometimes, you know, it's easy to kind of get away from that and, you know, start thinking about other things. But the main thing is like he literally redeemed us.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like paid for our sins, right? Set us free, right? And even knowing that, like, it's really important for us to count the cost, like, what he paid for. You know what I'm saying? And the more we understand that, the more we're going to love him, the more we're going to walk in him, and it's a joy doing it. You know what I'm saying? It's a joy. It's a peace. It's like, ooh, you know what, Lord, I want to do more. I want to get closer to you. I want to seek you more. And this year right here has been like a different year, right? It's been a different year. When I say a different year for me. It's kind of like this year for prayer, and I need to press in even more, right? It's kind of like the Lord, he wants so much more from us, right? And when I say so much more, not even from a, you know, but it's almost like for your good, so yeah. Much more.
Not like from a work standpoint.
Yeah, not from a work at all.
Like a seeking.
Yeah, that's it. And I really believe it's one of those, how he told the apostles, right? When they were in the garden, you know, pray least ye enter into temptation. You know what I'm saying? It's almost like when we praying because there's some stuff ahead, right, that he wants us to be prepared for. You know what I'm saying? And it's really, a blessing in that place, and he's such a good father that like he's always just telling us what's beneficial and not just for us, but for everybody around us. You know what I'm saying? For everybody around us. And even with saying that, I believe the Lord really want to deal with our hearts. You see what I'm saying? Really deal with our hearts and have us really just be honest with ourselves. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what, Lord, I'm kind of slacking. And like I said, this definitely, what I do want to understand, a lot of times messages like these be kind of hard because people think legalism right away. You know what I'm saying? When the Lord just really trying to get us, you know, hey, let's line it up a little bit and we're going to get into scripture with it all. But I share with y'all what happened to me. I think it was Friday. All right, so I got a brother, right? Well, he like a brother. He ain't my real brother, but he like a brother. And he actually one of the only people I talked to every blue moon, right, that actually knew me from before, right? We super tight. We were super, super, super tight. But every now and then we'll talk every blue moon. We drive trucks. And he had called me up. And I'm just, you know, just kind of chilling. And he said, hey, man, let me ask you some advice, right? He said, now, you know, I normally wouldn't ask you this. I should have knew then. Right? I should have knew then this was going somewhere that ain't had no business going, right? So he said, he asked me about, you know, I guess advice as far as single advice, I say that, right? He's single. He ain't married. And he's like, man, you know, I'm not normally going to ask you about, you know, single advice or about a woman or anything like that. Because he pretty much know where I stand. I tell him, like, look, only kind of single advice I can give you is you don't have sex until you get married. Right? And he don't want to hear that. Yeah. Right? So he asked me, you know, he asked me a question. And before I knew it, like, toward the end of the conversation, this done went somewhere totally left. Right? Mm. And the minute I got off the phone with him, it's like warships and warplanes just came at my soul, came at my mind. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because literally, you know, it was a conversation. And I'm going to be honest with you. It wasn't even, like, it wasn't nothing weird where I'm cutting. You know what I'm saying? It was just a conversation that wasn't edifying, right? And even with that conversation, I had to look in my heart and be honest with myself and say, you know what? That conversation didn't edify anybody in that situation. And at the same time, when we do find ourselves in them situations or concerns of the heart, you can't really see God in the midst of that situation. I just say, the pure in heart. You know what I'm saying? The pure in heart shall see God. Right? The pure in heart. And even with that situation, what I'm saying is, the wisdom of God would tell us to stay away from them conversations because he knows the fruit of what comes after those conversations. You see what I'm saying? So right after the conversation, all of a sudden, I got to cast down thoughts, and I'm talking about stuff I ain't thought about in years.
Amen.
Right? But that was connected to that conversation. You see what I'm saying? So it's the wisdom of God when he tells us, like, nah, don't find yourself in those conversations or just, when he tells us command, it's always wisdom from above. It's always good, and it's always brought forth to bring forth fruit. Always. Right? So, and I say this too, and this might not necessarily be connected to that, right? But that morning, I was rushing. Talking about I ain't really getting my word like I wanted to. I ain't really getting in that place of prayer like I wanted to. So it was almost like that hour of temptation that was coming, I was asleep just like the apostle, right?
Right.
And this ain't no condemnation against, you know what I'm saying? Because I know, you know, I'm forgiven, and it wasn't like that, but I'm just sharing and being open with you guys sometimes what happened when we put ourselves in certain situations. You know what I'm saying? It's almost like you put yourself through unnecessary battles, right? Unnecessary wars. So now, guess what? I got to cast down imaginations and thoughts that come and try to exalt itself above the work and above what the Lord is doing. You see what I'm saying? So even with saying that, right, how do we guard our hearts, right? Let's look at Proverbs. We're going to go to Proverbs chapter 4.
Hey, John.
Go ahead.
Hey, sometimes too, when you get outside of boundaries, whoever we're talking to, whether it's a person or a group, now they think it's okay to get outside of those boundaries, and now even dealing with that, you're like, wow, did I just do this guy incorrectly?
That's it.
If it's just a degree.
Yeah, it's still a stumbling block.
I heard somebody teaching one time, they said, they were talking about World War II.
Mm-hmm.
They said if the United States aircraft carriers would have been off by 1 degree, by the time they got to Japan, they would have been in enemy territory. You know, so even just 1 degree off.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Get you messed up.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You know, and then you got to try to go back and clean it up.
Yeah.
You know, and then it just
absolutely. And I think, too, that's the biggest thing, too, because, you know, we don't want to be a stumbling block, right? We don't want to be a stumbling block. And we want to, I say, even with that situation, guess what? The conversation didn't go straight there. Right? So it even kind of give you a picture on how things take place. They'll gradually try to step in and seep in. You see what I'm saying? And that's why right away it's so important that we go, like, we literally guard our hearts. What we're listening to, what we're watching, what we're saying. Right? Because if you don't, deception will kind of slip in there, and now all of a sudden it becomes a bigger problem. See what I'm saying? It becomes a bigger problem. We're gonna look at Psalm 1-2 after we read this. So you literally see it is a progression, right? It's a progression. Proverbs chapter 4, we'll start at 20. My son, give attention to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. Do not let them depart from your eyes. Keep them in the midst of your heart, for they are life to those who find them and health to all their flesh. Check this out. Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it springs the issues of life. Put away from you a deceitful mouth and put perverse lips far from you. Let your eyes look straight ahead and your eyelids look right before you. Ponder the path of your feet and let all your ways be established. Do not turn to the right or to the left. Remove your foot from evil. Guess what? Set your eyes on him, right? That's all we got to do. Look on to him. Often finish of our faith. Like, really set our minds on Jesus, because he is the perfect example, right? It's literally us looking at the light, looking at the word. And that's one thing that's so often about him. He'll always bring, that's why I said, and the word says, the pure in heart shall see God, right? So, whatever our heart is, I guess, hardened or darkened in certain situations, it's hard for us to see him. You see what I'm saying? There was a time in the New Testament when the apostles had forgot to take some bread, right? They had forgot to take some bread. And the Lord, we'll look at that real quick too, Mark 8. Y'all don't mind flipping through scriptures, do y'all?
No.
Y'all don't mind flipping through scriptures.
I love that.
You love that? You love that, Jack?
Yeah.
Mark 8, we'll start at 11, right? It says, then the Pharisees came out and began to dispute with him, talking about Jesus, seeking from him a sign from heaven, testing him. But he sighed deeply in his spirit and said, why does this generation seek a sign? Assuredly, I say to you, no sign should be given to this generation. And he left them, and getting into the boat again, departed to the other side. Now the disciples had forgotten to take bread. Now, earlier in chapter 8, he already fed 4,000, right? He already fed 4,000. Verse 16. And they reasoned among themselves, saying, it is because we have no bread. But Jesus, being aware of it, said to them, why do you reason because you have no bread? Do you not yet perceive nor understand? Is your heart still hardened? Having eyes, do you not see? And having ears, do you not hear? And do you not remember? When I broke the 5 loaves for the 5,000, how many baskets full of fragments did you take up? They said to him, 12. Also, when I broke the 7 for the 4,000, how many large baskets full of fragments did you take up? And they said, 7. So he said to them, how is it you do not understand? So you literally see, right? They hearts was hardened, but they was unable to see God in the midst of a situation because their heart was hardened and it wasn't pure. You see that? And unless our hearts are pure, we'll miss out on the things of God that's there for us a lot of times. You see what I'm saying? Because we have our own mindset or we thinking the wrong way about it. And the Lord's saying, nah, this area right here, we need to shed some light on. We need to shed some revelation on, right? And the Lord is always the one that brings light and revelation to every situation. Like, it's always him. Let's go to Ephesians chapter 5.
Stronghold or evil stronghold is life and death in the power of the tongue. So going back to the conversation.
Absolutely. And I think too, you know, and that's why really even seeing ourselves how Christ sees us is so important. You know what I'm saying? And us confessing that. You know what I'm saying? A lot of times you know, we had the wrong mindset and see ourselves the wrong way. And we'll speak it. You know what I'm saying? And just like that, that's another stronghold being put up that's going to have to get tore down for us to be able to get where we want to and see things the way he wants us to see. See what I'm saying? I can't be saying something different from what the Lord is saying about myself. Yeah. See what I'm saying? Like, I can't say, you know, I'm this, I'm that, I'm this, when he's saying I'm righteous in him.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm more than a conqueror. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. I got to say the same thing that he says, because if I don't, I'll find my heart being hardened, right? And guess what? Where he want me to see him in a situation, I won't be able to see him because my heart ain't pure.
Another gospel, I think it was John.
Yeah.
It has the same dissertation here where they're in the boat and they're all like, oh man, he's like, beware the leaven of the Pharisees. And like, oh man, we forgot. And he says the same story and he looks at them and he goes, I am the bread.
Mm.
Right? I am the bread.
Woo.
And so, like you said, they had their mind on bread.
Yep.
Instead of on him.
Amen.
And so Matthew 6:33, when we put our mind on him and our heart's pure, everything else comes.
Everything else.
Everything that we need. Yep. And he's not saying you're gonna have abundant bread. He said you're gonna have abundant life.
Amen.
Life and life more abundant.
Amen. Amen. Because the problem is whenever we try to mix them, it's gonna be perverted. You know what I'm saying?
It ain't right.
Yeah, it ain't right. You know what I'm saying?
Or Pastor says, Jesus ain't no slot machine either.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I love you, Jesus. No. It's either you serve him or you don't.
That's it.
He's not a give him something to get something kind of, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Even though that's what happens.
Yeah.
But that's not the why.
Yeah, that's not exactly, that's not the why. That's not the main thing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's not the main thing. He's the main thing. It's for us to imitate him, walk in him, follow him, trust him, and love him. That's what it's about. You know what I'm saying?
My grandma used to read the scripture to me, or quote it to me. It's like, a good name is better than great riches.
Right.
I never understood what that really meant until these years. You know, where if you ask somebody about me, if you were to put something on my gravestone, it would be, this dude loved Jesus. You know what I'm saying? Like, everything that I've done or haven't done or whatever, my failures, if you ask people who knew me, what do you think about that guy? Oh, he loves the Lord. He does what he loves people.
Yep.
You know, that name is greater than any riches. Like, who God has created me to be is greater than any possession that I have. That name that he's given. As a son, right, as a follower of him, that I'm known by that is a prized possession.
Absolutely.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely. And the thing is, too, you know, that's why it's kind of like when you got him, you got everything. You know what I'm saying? Like, you like literally, we have him. We have everything.
Joint heirs.
We need everything.
With Christ.
Right? Everything.
Joint heirs.
Joint
sons.
Heirs. Amen. Amen. And that's how, and that's the truth of it. It's kind of like everything we have need of is in him. You know what I'm saying? That's why I like that in John 14, where you see them, every question that the apostles had, Philip, you know, show us the Father, and then we'll be, you know, where is the way? He was the answer to every single question they asked.
Been with me this long?
I'm the way. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When you see me, you've seen the Father. You know what I'm saying? So, and that's what's so, he's the answer to every situation. Mm-hmm. In him is every spiritual blessing. You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
And I think sometimes we'll pull away from that and we'll just forget. Like, you know what? I had all things like in him. Like I said, I'm an open book. You know what I'm saying? I can share this to my mama. Probably don't watch, right? Right.
Hopefully.
But you know, I had talked to her yesterday, and she was telling my mama. She prayed. She a prayer warrior. That's what I call her, prayer warrior. And I called her because she was sick a couple days ago. So I was like, "Hey, mama, you know how you doing?" She was like, "Well, I'm good, but emotionally, I'm just not, you know." And then she started kind of going over the past with her and my dad relationship and all that. And I said, Mom, I said, I said, you telling me about all the stuff that happened in the past, Mama? That stuff was 50, 40 years ago. I said, but you going over it like it was yesterday, like it's current. You know what I'm saying? I said, Mama, you got to let that go. You know what I'm saying? I said, guess what? You got everything in him. Like, everything you have need of is in him. If you feel like you lacking, ask. You know what I'm saying? And in the word, you see that with David, the Lord literally told David, even after the rebuke, like, you know, during the rebuke, he said, I did all this for you, right? And if there was anything else, all you had to do was ask, I would have gave it to you. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's the blessing when we really know him. Like, we don't lack anything. Like, we literally have everything we had need of. Everything we had need of. You know what I'm saying? But back to my mama, it was just more like sometimes we'd get stuck on the past and not even realize it. Mama, like, even with us being born again, that's one of the blessings of being, you literally born again. Old things are passed away, like a new creation. Like, there's nowhere else you getting that. You ain't getting that. No, what you got, Chris?
No, that's what I'm saying. It's so important that we surround ourselves with people of God that are going to lift us up. Place,
amen.
To get us back on track, you know, because that's the language of the world.
Yeah, exactly. They venting, right? Yeah. Venting. I just want to vent. And I'm like, okay, let me hear you. I hear you. Nah, you know what, Mama? We've been talking about this too long. Like, I wasn't even born with this
get
stuff
off
to play.
Chair,
this is a new day, Mama. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, you know your best days ahead of you, Mama. You know what I'm saying? Sound like Joel Osteen for a minute, like, you know. And it was, but it was the truth. Like, you know, I said, Mama, because she knows she just talked about, you know, and she wouldn't mind me sharing this because it's the things of God too. Right? It's a blessing. She was talking about just, you know, how bad the marriage was in the past and this and that. I said, but Mama, I said, you think about it. You got three children that have great spouses now. They have great marriages now. I said, so instead of complaining and thinking on all that negative stuff, be thankful and thank God for the good stuff, right?
Yeah.
And the thing that you done prayed for, and guess what? The peace of God will come in and you'll be all right. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, that's the answer to anxiety. Setting your mind on the things above, those good things. You see what I'm saying?
Ahead to the future.
Amen. Yeah. Like that's what it's about. We can't stay, you know, focused on the past. But guess what? We've been born again. It don't get no better than that. We're literally saying, guess what? Even today, right? We can confess and say today, you know what? Lord, today is a new day. Today is the day of salvation. And anything we were struggling with yesterday was yesterday. You know what I'm saying? But actually being confident and being able to call those things that be not as though they were. You know what I'm saying? And knowing that with God all things are possible, we can press into what he wants us to be. Go ahead, Chris. What you got?
I got a good Old Testament passage. As you know, Abraham, he's a follower of faith.
Yep.
He started as Abram. God changed his name. Abraham means father of many nations. So before he even had a child, God started to call things to be not as though they were. He changed his name. So when he called him out, Abraham was 75 years old.
Mm.
His wife was barren. He didn't even have children. God said, I'll make you a father of many nations. So, of course, he had doubt. You know, there was some doubt in there. But in Genesis chapter 15, verse 1, you know, God's speaking to Abraham. At this point, it's Abram. He hasn't changed his name yet. He's given this big vision. There's some doubt there. And God said, after these things, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision, saying, do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield. You're receiving great reward. So God is the reward, right? He's the reward.
Amen.
And everything comes out of him.
I see how he's the reward. Those diligently seeking him, he is the reward. Like you said, you don't get no better reward than him. You know what I'm saying? Because in him is everything we had needed.
Like you tell Mama, forget the one, focus on the three.
It's a blessing in there. Let's look at Ephesians chapter 5 real quick.
You said something about Psalms 1 too.
Yeah. Psalms 1. Now, like I said, that's where you see that progression. You know what I'm saying? That progression, because you know, that's what sin is, deceitful at. A lot of times we just think that, you know, boom, you just fall in a situation. A lot of times, you know, when you see affairs and certain things take place, a seed is sown with those. You know what I'm saying? And it just grows and it turns into something. That's why it's important for us to guard our hearts. And guess what? When something there, it ain't got no business being there, a thought or anything like that, nah, we cast it down. See what I'm saying? We run it out the garden. You know what I'm saying?
You don't fall into bed with somebody.
Nah, exactly. You don't. Yeah, it's a process. It's a, you know, and even as far as with certain things, like, I'm gonna be honest with you, even like with these phones, right? Your phone gonna tell on you. Because whatever you look at, guess what? All of a sudden, this popping up, this popping up, this popping up. You see what I'm saying? And why they call it, it's the algorithm. They call it the algorithm. You see what I'm saying? So whatever you letting in there is going to keep coming in until you get rid of it. Mm,
that's good.
You see what I'm saying? That's why a lot of times, you know, I don't care. And I say this is how the phone is, the technology now in general. Whatever they think you like, that's what they're going to see. Yeah. That's what they're going to see.
They hear it. You could be talking about a green leaf, blah, 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 and not even type it in. And the next thing you know, Facebook.
It's coming up. It's coming
so
up.
If you always talking about ladies and blah, 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 you might get some lady apps come up or something.
Absolutely.
You better.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And even with the process of that, as far as another great example, as far as biblically, as far as somebody with the heart situation, is Saul. Like, we see it in Saul. Like, you literally see Saul go to a dark, dark, dark place where he literally looking to seek advice. When I say Saul, I'm talking about King Saul from the Old Testament. You literally see him going to get counsel from a witch, right? From a witch. So you go from, you know, being the king of Israel and the first king of Israel and loving on David, you know what I'm saying, to literally becoming a madman, where, you know, but it all started because he didn't
obey.
Obey? Yeah, he didn't obey.
And he let voices in he shouldn't have.
Yeah, exactly. He didn't guard his heart. You see what I'm saying? He didn't guard his heart. And how do we guard our hearts? How do we know how to? By the word of God. You know what I'm saying? By the word of God. Ephesians chapter 5, real quick. How much time? I ain't got my clock.
10 minutes.
10 minutes.
10 minutes, okay. Ephesians chapter 5. It says, therefore be imitators of God as dear children and walk in love, as Christ also has loved us and given himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet smelling aroma. But fornication and all uncleanness or covetousness, let it not even be named among you as is fitting for saints. Neither filthiness nor foolish talking nor coarse jesting, which are fitting, but rather giving of thanks. For this you know, that no fornicator, unclean person, nor covetous man who is an idolater has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and God. Let no one deceive you with empty words, for because of these things, the wrath of God comes upon the sons of disobedience. Therefore, do not be partakers with them. Verse 8. For you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Walk as children of light. For the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness, righteousness, and truth. Finding out what is acceptable to the Lord, and have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather expose them. Right? And to sum this up real quick, we just got to be holy. Right? Be holy as he's holy. Holy one of the words we be scared of now. Like, holy, you'll never be holy. You know what I'm saying? But the Bible tells us to be holy, right? And that holiness, it comes from him. You know what I'm saying? But we do have to come out, and we can't, like, it ain't no reason for me to profess to be a Christian but live like the world, just keeping it real, right? I said, we in the world, but we're not of the world, right? And there is a sanctification or a setting apart that takes place. You see what I'm saying? If I'm out of line, and I think, too, an accountability, that's why brotherhood is so important, because accountability is important. If Josh see me tripping and doing something crazy, having an affair on my wife, he need to get on me.
Yeah, restore your brother in gentleness. Yeah.
Period.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, just keep, like, period. You know, and I think, go ahead, what you got?
I think when I'm faced with some transgression and I feel iniquity,
yeah,
because I'm sure if all of us can feel it, I feel it instantly.
Yeah.
Even though it's not full-blown sin, the iniquity's there. If I have the ability to turn from the sin and hit 1 John 1:9, if I confess my sin, he is faithful and just to cleanse me of my sin and forgive me of my sin and cleanse me from all unrighteousness.
Amen.
That right there, the faster I do that, I believe that's the holiness that's to be had in that. Of course, I'm not holy.
Yeah.
But as soon as I turn from it and seek
this,
him.
This is the thing we got to understand, too, how you say, even with anger and stuff like that, how you say, be angry and sin not. Mm-hmm. And I think, too, one thing about it, once we become born again, the Lord gives us a new heart.
Yeah.
Because before, you probably wouldn't even thought twice about it.
Mm-hmm.
You just would have went straight there.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So whenever, you know, we remind and saying, like, nah, this ain't right, it's a blessing in that. Because I'm going to tell you, like, that, even like that little conversation I had the other, what? That was the norm.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that was the norm. So, to be corrected and to see things the way he see them, it's a blessing in that. The problem comes when we don't yield to him in them situations.
Mm-hmm.
Our heart become hardened to the situation. So, guess what? The next conversation is worse than the last.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? What you got, Chris?
I was going to say, God wants to father us.
Amen.
You know, we got to have that open communication with him.
Amen.
You know, it says, call no man on earth father.
Mm-hmm.
Because we shouldn't wait. It shouldn't be like one day a week I go and spew all this stuff out.
Yeah.
It should be an ongoing relationship where I miss it. And if I get a little off track, then he brings me back. You know, he whispers and says, hey,
amen. Hey,
that conversation, what, you know, that wasn't right, you know.
Yeah.
And it's not like a mean, it's just like I love you.
Yeah, because he wants the best
for
us.
I want to protect you. I want to stay in communication with you. I want you to walk in this abundant life. You know, and it's when we ignore that voice, or maybe even start to exalt somebody up, and then putting a lot of pressure and weight on them to be your Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
You know, instead of leaning into the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And having a relationship with him.
That's good. That's good. What you got?
And like my pastor saying, when he was like, I don't know, 14 back in verse, he's like 99, you know, and he said the guy that he looked up to the most was telling this dirty joke in the store, and he said it just shattered him, you know, knowing that he looked up to him so much, and then, you know, he said that really fueled him to be a preacher, you know.
Yeah, because it's important. I mean, because,
yeah.
You know, y'all do a lot of street evangelism, right? What's one of the biggest things y'all hear when y'all go out there?
Don't want
to
go there
and
be a hypocrite.
Yeah, hypocrite, right? That's the number. That's the number one thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. So even when we talk about holiness, it's just seeing things and doing things the way he was doing, right? But it's the Spirit of God that makes us holy. It ain't, you know, it ain't nothing we can do. So I definitely ain't saying, like, you know, if you wear all white and you walking around with your head, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Nah, I'm saying, you know, us doing what he called us to do and being set apart for his work. You see what I'm saying? Like, cause we literally are a royal priesthood, right?
Yeah.
And being part of the royal priesthood and being that peculiar people, we are set apart for the Lord's work, right? It's certain tools in here that's set apart just for a certain job. Like, you can take one tool and try to do something else with it. You're totally using it against his will, right?
Amen.
Totally, right? But it's, yep, exactly. But if you take the tool that's designed specifically for that task, it's gonna do what it's supposed to do. You see what I'm saying? And that's and we to be used by him, right? We his vessels. You know what I'm saying? Like, we his vessels. But I'm probably getting ready to wrap up, right? Yeah. But
we gotta read that Psalms 1. I really.
Yeah, I got you. I'm glad you said that too, John. I'm going to tell you, I'm supposed to read Revelation chapter 3, too, about the lukewarm church. We ain't getting that. Right? But nah, he want us to walk in the light, man, and just be that light.
You got 4 minutes.
You can
get
4 minutes. Psalm 1. Let's get it. I'm glad you said it, too, Jeff.
I just
want to
read that Revelation
2
on the way out.
You
want to
read
that
Revelation on the way out?
Yeah, closing prayer. Oh, yeah.
All right.
Pastor, get some time
from
me, man.
Oh, yeah, get some time. All right, Psalms 1. It says, blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners. Right? So we see walking, right? And then you see standing. And I always, in my head, I always kind of think about somebody just walking, you know, down the block, and then they stop and having a conversation with the guys
right.
on the block.
And they sit on the stoop.
There you go, right?
That's it.
It said, nor stands in the paths of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like, and this is us right here, he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. But nah, but we like I said, the blessing is, you know, we like that tree planted by the river. Like I, you know, I believe that by faith, you know what I'm saying? And we're gonna bear fruit and continue to be a blessing to the kingdom of God, right? Continue to seek his face, continue to put him first, and put off the works of darkness. You know what I'm saying? Like put off, because we really do gotta be set apart for him. You know what I'm saying? There's certain areas where you know, right, that you got, you know, and it might not be pleasing, or it might just be a weight to keep us from running the race that he has for us. Be honest, be real, and let's get it right. You know what I'm saying? Because there's so much the Lord is doing and wants to do in us, because, you know, we're in the last days, right? In the last days. But he's doing a great work, man. And he just, glory just getting brighter and brighter, brighter and brighter and brighter. And who want to be involved? Like, that's, I mean, that's it. I mean, you want to join or not? Because it's happening, right? It's happening. But I love y'all. I close out the prayer. And go from there. All right. Oh, gracious Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for my brothers. We thank you so much, Lord, for dying for us, Lord. While we were yet sinners, you died for us, Lord. Your love is amazing. You are love, Lord. You are everything we need. Even as we go out through the day, Lord, let us be a blessing unto somebody. Lord, we know that in you we have every spiritual blessing. And we just thank you, Lord, that your grace is sufficient for every situation. We thank you for saving us. We thank you for the precious blood of the Lamb. We just honor you on today. Let us just continue to put you first and set our mind on the things above, not on the things beneath. And even our family, we thank you for our families, Lord, and covering them. We thank you for your angels being encamped round about us as we go riding around on these roads. And we just thank you. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Right.
There you are.
Amen.
Sit down.